Hey guys, welcome back. This week, we'll discuss a backdoor developer tool that stole credentials for 3 months without notice, the Fin7 hacking group leader being sentenced for 10 years, Google Project Zero changes the bug disclosure policy, and our CVE of the week, a vulnerability in OverlayFS allows local users under Ubuntu to gain root privileges. We'll start with the software development tool containing malicious code that stole apps credentials. The tool, CodeCov Bash Uploader, is used by developers to send coverage reports that show how much of a code was tested and used by GitHub Actions, CircleCI, and Bitrise Step. Last week, it was discovered that Bash Uploader contained the malicious backdoor from late January up to the beginning of April. This malicious code is part of a supply chain attack that has the potential to backdoor the networks of countless organizations. It works by sending the GitHub repository location and the entire process environment, like tokens and credentials, to the remote site, giving attackers a lot of information about the organizations where this code ran. It seems that the malicious backdoor was put inside Bash Uploader around January through unauthorized access to Google Cloud Storage. CodeCov advises users to check whether they have this command string in their program. If you find this command, we advise you to replace your program with the latest version of Bash Uploader. In other news, one of the leaders of Fin7 hacking group was sentenced to prison in the US. The Fin7 leader was sentenced to 10 years in prison after pleading guilty to wire fraud and computer hacking accusations in 2019. Being part of the Fin7 hacking group, he was accused of targeting multiple firms and individuals, compromising tens of millions of debit and credit cards. Fin7 had specifically targeted the restaurant, gaming, and hospitality industries by sending spear phishing emails containing decoy documents with the goal of stealing customers' payment card data. Their operations are estimated to have caused damages of over $3 billion to banks, credit card companies, and consumers starting in 2015. The hacker was accused of spearheading these operations and, in addition to his jail time, would also have to pay a fine of $2.5 million in restitution. Moving on, Google Project Zero has released new disclosure policies. Up to now, researchers gave the vendors 90 days to patch, after which they disclosed the vulnerabilities publicly, whether a patch was developed or not. This change gives vendors that had used the 90 days period to develop a patch another 30-day grace period before publicly disclosing the bugs. These 30 days to patch are also given to vulnerabilities discovered in the wild, greatly scaling it from the 7-day period that is usually given in these situations. Google made this decision to reward vendors who patch quickly and with the hope of giving more time for patches to be adopted by users. Now, for our CVE of the week, a vulnerability in OverlayFS allows local users under Ubuntu to gain root privileges. Ubuntu is a popular operating system for cloud computing in Linux. OverlayFS is a union mount file system implementation for Linux, working as a single directory that contains underlying files and subdirectories for all sources. An independent researcher reported to SSD that attackers using this system could gain root privileges if they're using Ubuntu. This vulnerability can occur in OverlayFS due to a patch carried in Ubuntu. This patch is meant to allow unprivileged OverlayFS mounts, but in the process also makes the application to improperly validate file system capabilities with respect to user namespaces. SSD had reported this vulnerability to Ubuntu, who fixed it and provided patches correcting it. That's it for now. More details about what we just mentioned can be found in the description below. Don't forget to follow us on our other channels to keep up with the latest news and advisories.